Hello!
Hi!
Thank you for having me over.
I finally get to discover your tea collection and like see these hundreds of teas that you poured it in your house apparently. Okay, first things first, am I supposed to call you Aditi or am I just supposed to say like Rajkumari, Aditi Rao
Hydari? Okay, what do you really call me?
Okay, in reality I call her Adu because I think everyone calls
you
Adu.
Okay, and now you can prefix, is there a prefix? Yeah, that with a HRH, simple.
So you wanted to say Her Royal Highness Adu.
Totally.
Yeah, like anti-climax of our name, but did you just realize?
You have to be like not obvious, right?
Her Royal Highness Aditi Rao Hydari. Okay, just to give you guys perspective, basically both sides of Aditi's family come from royalty. And we also have one more thing in common with us, not the royal part, but the fact that we're both Mangies.
Oh yes, we are.
Mangalorians,
proud Mangies. Yes, very
yes.
Proud Mangies.
Okay, but now let's take a look at your house.
So I've been here in Bombay now about 8 years, almost nine. Mm-hmm. And like over time, this place has become the way it has, and like literally everything I've just picked myself.
Tell me about the house that you grew up in, because I mean when we say royalty on both sides and we talk about living in Hyderabad and you know any city other than Mumbai, I've realized, has bigger homes.
Yeah.
Like Bombay has the tiniest homes, right? So yeah. What kind of house did you grow up in?
So my home in Hyderabad and all like my everybody's homes in Hyderabad are really very different. They also function very differently, and there's that whole, you know, system of staff and who have been there with you for years.
Matlab your great grandmother hired them,
they're still there. And then there's our place back home in Vanpati, so that also functions in a very, very different way. I was born in Hyderabad and I spent a lot of time there, but I grew up with my mom in Delhi, and my life in Delhi was very different from my life in Hyderabad. So I grew up actually like I wouldn't say hippie, but I do have a very free spirit vibe, which is very much a part of who I am, but at the same time I am also very like
proper,
three bags full. Yes.
Tell me one thing, so you know, given the kind of spaces that you guys have lived in,
yeah,
then when your family visits you here, and I'm assuming this must be for anyone they visit in Mumbai, they must
very
be like,
good question,
why would you live in this city?
It's such a good question, because in fact my nani, when she, my amama I call her, when she first came to Bombay, she was claustrophobic. In 2 days, she was just like, okay, I love you very much, but I can't take this. My nana, there's no chance that he would have been able to even, like, also he was like very tall and he had this very sort of imposing personality. I can't even imagine him in this house. Like, I feel like his persona would not have space in this house.
And it is lunchtime. And I was passing Aditi's kitchen and I
you smelled nice.
Yeah, there's way too many
dishes.
I hope
they taste nice as well, because I haven't walked into the kitchen today.
So shall we go? Shall we get the food?
Yeah.
Huh? Chalo.
I hope you like it. I'm hungry.
Acha, where do I keep what?
That's next to you.
Chicken next to me.
How the hell do I get this?
Here?
Yeah. There's no OCD-ness in khatirdari and feeding people.
Adu, I love you. Tumko kya lagta hai ki hum log kitna khana khate? I mean, how much food am I going to eat? So let me tell you guys what all is on the table, okay? This is like mehman nawazi at its best. There is this very, I don't know what these aloos are called, but I mean, I know that it's typically South Indian because my mouth is watering. I'm talking.
I'm so happy. I hope it also tastes good.
Okay, so this is, what is this aloo called?
I actually don't know.
But
it's
like
the kind
aloo.
Of aloo that everybody loves.
Yeah. This is ghee roast chicken, you guys. This entire chicken has been made in ghee. This is prawns.
Yeah.
Yeah. Was it like
and
a
coconut
special
milk? Like, you know that West Coast prawns.
Huh. Huh. Okay, and this is of course my favorite bhaji, which we have now established on the show. I love beans.
Poriel, huh?
Beans, French beans, yeah.
Poriel, it's called.
Poriel, okay, I didn't know that that's what it's called. 1 second, what is in this?
That's ghee. Oh, this is.
There is ghee at the table while we are eating lunch. Why is there ghee?
Because I have to have ghee with every meal and with my coffee, and there's like basically I bathe in ghee.
It's your coffee also. Oh, is it that bullet coffee and you put ghee in it instead of butter?
Yeah.
Come on, Adu, now serve me.
I'll serve you.
Look how demanding of me. Serve me. I need food.
prawns I won't give you.
Tell me about why you wanted to be an actor.
I think even as a kid, I was photographed a lot. Hmm. So because my Masi studied at Cambridge, her friends would come to India. They all came with cameras. I was the only child around. Hmm. Again, mother's open house. There would be all these people milling about and like constantly photographing me. So I just got really, really comfortable in front of the camera and I used to say, come, we'll play photo, photo. I really liked being a performing monkey. Hmm. And then I started dancing when I was really little. Hmm. And I think, like, I always feel like acting is like an extension of dancing and vice versa. And then I saw a film called Bombay, which was Mani Sir's film, and I was just so mesmerized by just the way that it looked and how like beautiful it was. And I was just like, I want to do that. I want to be that person. Like, basically, I wanted to be Manisha Kira. Mm. I was like, I want to be that person. And like, I literally just wanted to run in and be that person.
Did you feel like the first time you were on a Mani Ratnam set, like, you know, oh God, I feel like life is coming a bit of a full circle. You're like, at least career-wise, to think of it as a child who wanted to be on a set with Mani Ratnam.
Oh my God.
And now to actually be working with
him. Absolutely. When something like this happens, it actually gets reaffirmed. That, you know, when you really dream and when you really, really want something, but somehow it happens.
Are you proud of me, Aditi?
I'm really proud of you.
Plate.
But you've eaten one piece
Please
of chicken.
Don't like focus on my fingers, which are disgusting right now. Before I burp on camera, let's go keep these back.
And before my trainer finds me eating ghee roast chicken.
And you're of course making me a cup of tea, no? Like
of course
to,
I am.
Yeah.
Of course. Getting some purple tea now.
Purple?
Yeah.
This I want to see.
See? It's actually purple.
This looks like...
And it's
like
cold tea.
Oh,
did you want hot tea?
No.
You
this
have
is
to
good.
Have like my
no, no.
kind of tea.
Whatever you're comfortable.
It's like really nice in summer.
This looks like a witch's potion. But like I mean it in a good way. Adu, are you ready for
yes.
quick
oh,
bites?
Oh my God.
With Janice.
Yes, okay, done.
What's a polite way to tell someone that they have kanda breath?
There is no polite way to do that. Just have to stay away.
What's the most icky thing someone can do while eating?
Like, there is very little that really annoys me.
Huh.
This is one.
What's the one thing you hate about set ka khana?
There has soda in it and everything tastes the same. But South Indian set ka khana is different.
Correct.
Oh my God, it's so good. First of all, it's all mirchi. And then there'd be this like mirchi wala chicken or mirchi wala mutton. And they have all kinds of like, especially the Telugu industry, like Andhra food especially, has a lot of like chutneys and podis, you know what podis are?
Yeah.
So they have a lot of that. I love the breakfast.
Again, they're also breakfast.
Because you can idli, dosa, vada, upma, and it's endless. And I can eat idli for breakfast, lunch and dinner.
Huh.
Idli, ghee, podi. Breakfast, lunch and dinner.
What's the one thing that you constantly order in? What?
I don't constantly do it. But if I have done a really, like if I've worked on a really long schedule, then I'm feeling sorry for myself.
Sorry
you know, I have this,
myself.
Yeah, like I have this, you know, I need to pamper myself. I need to be bad now. So I go through like a few days like that. And then that day I will order in a pizza.
It's not such a big crime.
It is. And no, it's not ending there. And a box of After Eight. And that box of After Eight would be like pretty much over. And I'm so embarrassed at myself that I literally like pretend like I'm not eating other. Oh, how many itne khali? It's like that. I try not to eat sugar, okay? So I either eat jaggery or maple or agave or whatever. And then, but the thing is, I'm an ant. I really like sugar. So, but I don't eat it. And then it's the same thing. It's like tasting blood. So you eat one and then you're like, one
whole
more,
packet
one
gone.
One more.
Have you ever had a meal that was better than sex?
That's saying too much now. Either way, you get fucked.
Which co-star's dabba do you love reading?
So when I was shooting for Dhanush's film. Mm. We were in a village in Tamil Nadu, and his spot, is also an amazing cook. And there was, at some point, I stopped eating set ka khana, and me, these two girls who were in my team and I, three of us and I, we one day just demanded food. Actually, they called us, and then for the first couple of times we were shy, and then we were like, we just came, knocked on the van, and we were like, we're eating. And then since then, like since that one day, we ate everybody together, every single day, and it was just the most insane food.
If you were throwing a royal daawat, what would be on the menu?
Haleem, Nihari, Hyderabad ka keema, dam ka keema, khubani ka meetha, and the kacche gosht ki biryani is really cool, which is made underground.
So you can't ever be vegetarian, can you?
Not a chance. There's a Hyderi in my blood, and that Hyderi is not going away anytime soon. And my South Indian side, like my grandfather's family, I told you they eat khichdi keema for breakfast.
So, yeah.
So there's no chance.
Hardcore now, non-vegetarians only.
And I love animals. I love animals. But somehow that connection between and doesn't happen.
Which three celebrity friends would top your guest list at this daawat?
Farah Khan, who feeds me all the time. Diya, because she's a fellow Hyderabadi. Uh-huh. Rajan Patra.
Okay. And finally, if you were being sent to a deserted island, what three food items would you carry with you?
I'm not going to a deserted island.
I'll tell you what she'll carry. She'll carry a goat.
I was going to be even more terrible. I'm going to carry like a goat couple. So they can... No, I didn't just say that.
But, I know it's almost time to wrap up. But you know I can't go without doing one thing, no? I've come all the way to your house on such a rainy day.
Oh my God, you're going to make me sing.
Two lines
I should
sing.
Make you sing for your supper.
I will do one thing on the side over there.
Hai Rama, ye kya hua? Kyun aise hame satane lage? Tum kitni pyari ho samne? Hum kaabu mein kaise rahe? Jaao, hum ko to aati sharm hai. Teri aise ada pe to fida hum hai. Hai Rama, ye kya hua? Kyun aise hame satane lage? Can't do more.
Oh, so good. Thank you so much for having me.
It's a place, Adu. I love the food, I love the tea, and I love your home. Thank you.
Happy you came.
Yes.
But you have to come back minus all these girls.
No cameras next time.
No cameras next time. Absolutely not.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Take care. Bye.
Okay, Janice, come again, okay? And thanks for coming.